Hello, my name is Georgios Papadopoulos and I have co-authored with Dimitris Sourailidis, Remos Aris Koutsiamanis, Dominic Barthel and Nicolas Montavont the paper named RFC 6550 on minimizing the control plane traffic of RPL-based industrial networks. This is being presented as part of the second international workshop on data distribution in industrial and pervasive internet, DIPI, that takes place virtually in conjunction with WoWMoM conference. I will proceed with presenting the necessary technical background related with RPL routing protocol. RPL is a proactive routing protocol produced by the IETF role working group. RPL builds a destination-oriented directed acyclic graph, DODAC, by employing a distance vector technique. In each DODAC, there is a single node considered to be the root, which serves as the gateway to other non-RPL networks. Based on a common objective function, each node selects one or more parents, acting as a relay towards the root node. In such a network, the traffic from non-root nodes towards the root is called the upstream traffic, while the reverse is called the downstream traffic. In order to form, maintain, and update a DODAC, the RPL nodes periodically transmit in broadcast DODAC Information Object DIO control packets. A DIO message carries DODAC related information such as RPL instance, DODAC ID, DODAC version number, or routing related metrics that will allow a node to select its parent. The time interval of the DIO transmissions depends on the network stability. Indeed, the more stable the network, the fewer the DIO packets sent in order to reduce the overhead. Correspondingly, when the network is not stable, more DIO messages are transmitted. This timing algorithm is called a trickle timer. RPL nodes transmit DIOs using a trickle timer. The trickle algorithm increases its interval or stays stable only if it detects transmissions that are consistent. Here you have a detailed overview of the RPL terminology with one RPL instance that consists of multiple DODACs. Now, a problem arises when a new device intends to join a DODAC. It turns its radio on and waits to receive a DIO. This is a typical use case from smart grid applications, when a smart meter is being replaced in the field while a RPL network is already operating. However, if the DODAC is in stable state, then the joining node will have to wait for a very long time. RFC 6550 supports a DODAC informational solicitation DIS control packet to optimize the joining procedure. Thus, a RPL node may employ a DIS message to solicit DIO messages from nearby RPL routers. However, since the new node does not have knowledge of the operating network, for example, which neighbor routers it should query, it solicits DIO's responses using a multicast DIS. As per RFC 6550 standard, when receiving a multicast DIS, the neighbor routers will reset their trickle timers and will immediately transmit their DIO's responses. The disadvantage of resetting the trickle timers is that the nodes will start transmitting their periodic DIOs at the shortest time interval for a considerable duration until the trickle timers reach again the relaxed time intervals. This procedure will introduce unnecessary control traffic in the network that will increase congestion and consequently will consume energy of the nodes, a problem on potentially battery-operated devices. In the reference below, you may find more use cases that prompt such unnecessary traffic and consequently the DIS modification. In this paper, we present several actions that can be done to enhance the behavior of the Ripple protocol at the control plane. For instance, flags in the DIS control packet could be introduced in order to reduce the unnecessary traffic. Then, in order to reduce the number of nodes that will respond to a DIS control packet, routing constraints in the DIS can be included. Thus, only the nodes that fulfill these constraints can respond to the DIS. Finally, we define an optional DIO response spreading mechanism to mitigate the potential collision on between DIO responses to a DIS multicast transmission. When a Ripple router receives a DIS message that includes the response spreading option, before attempting to send its DIO, it must first wait for a time randomly chosen from a time interval. More specifically, in the first case, when a Ripple router receives a multicast DIS control packet with the N flag set, it will not reset the trickle timer. Then the T flag specifies what type of DIO is sent in response when the N flag is set. Thus, when a multicast DIS control packet with the T flag set is received, a Ripple router receiving it must respond with the unicast DIO, while it must respond with the multicast DIO if this flag is unset. These two actions will essentially reduce the unnecessary traffic in the network. To further reduce the number of nodes that will respond to a DIS control packet, we propose to include routing constraints in the DIS control packet. Thus, only the nodes that fulfill these constraints can respond to the DIS. In this paper, we propose to augment the RFC 6550 standard by including a metric container option inside the DIS messages. For instance, in this scenario, only the nodes A and R will fulfill the constraints that were transmitted in the DIS and thus will send back a DIO. Comparing the theoretical performance of the default Ripple with no flags case against the N flag and the metric container option, as shown in this figure, the effect of the N flag significantly reduces the number of DIOs sent, while the metric container option further reduces these numbers. Our simulation environment involves 10 fixed Ripple nodes, including the dodag root in the topology shown here. Each node transmits UDP data packets at constant rate of one packet per 50 minutes. In this work, we are evaluating the effect of DIS parameters on the transmission of DIO control packets. Therefore, the UDP traffic rate is set at a low level to minimize the interference with control packet measurements. To study the effect of the augmented protocol with the additional flags and options, we have used a scenario where a node, node 6, enables and disables its radio every 30 minutes. It is kept enabled for 30 minutes and then disabled for 30 minutes. The 30 minutes interval is important because it is bigger than the largest trickle timer, while you saw the rest of the nodes which do not enable and disable their radios will have stabilized and reached the maximum trickle timer interval value. This reflects a stable network, so when node 6 tries to reconnect, we can examine the disturbance it creates on the rest of the stable nodes. Furthermore, we employed the IEEE 802.15.4 TACH at the MediaMax control layer with the 60s minimal as the scheduling function, while Ripple was employed at the routing protocol. Finally, all the proposed flags NTR and options metric container and response spreading have been implemented in Contiki NG, and all the simulations were done with the CUDA simulator. The details of the simulation setup are presented in the paper. First, we present the results from one of the replications in the following slides in the form of a timeline, of the events during a full 108 minutes simulation of the network. For the default Ripple implementation, meaning without flux and options, this figure shows that every time node 6 requests to join the network via multicast DIS after a period of disconnection, all nodes receiving the packet are triggered and have their trickle timers reset, and as a result, they start sending frequent DIOs. Note that the red color means that the node 6 has no Ripple parent, the green color means that the node 6 has a Ripple parent, while the gray background indicates the radio is off and therefore node 6 is disconnected. In contrast, when the nodes receive a multicast DIS with the NFLAG set as shown in this figure, they do not reset their trickle timers and they immediately respond with a DIO, therefore reducing the total multicast DIOs sent. Similarly, when both N and T flags are set, as shown here, the number of DIOs is further decreased since the DIOs are now also unicast and, as a result, suffer less interference. Adding the meter container option to N and T flags further reduces the number of transmitted DIOs, since now only a subset of neighbors that fulfill the constraints respond. However, the reduction is less dramatic than the introduction of the N flag, since there is more room for improvement there. Finally, when both the meter container and response spreading options are enabled in conjunction with N and T flags, it becomes clear that these are the best performing cases. As it can be observed, only the nodes that fulfill the constraints transmit the DIO control packets in unicast and at different time, which help the collision avoidance. A summarized view of the total number of DIOs sent in the network with all possible combinations is shown in this figure. The results demonstrate an overall reduction in the number of sent DIOs. Indeed, the combination of N and T flags and MC and RS options is the best choice when a node tries to connect to a Ripple-based network. In this work, we presented the problems of network traffic overhead created when a node joins a stable Ripple network. We investigated the problem of resetting of the Ripple trickle timer when multicast DIS control packets are received. The secondary problem was related with high traffic when multiple DIS receivers try to send their DIO responses at the same time. To solve these issues, we proposed an augmentation of RFC 6550 in the form of new flags and options for the DIS control packet. We implemented and evaluated our proposal in the Contiki NG operating system and the CUDA simulator, proving that the implementation is realistic and feasible. The results show very significant performance improvements in terms of reduced overhead. The next step is to expand the testing to much bigger topologies and to measure the impact of this proposal with different traffic and node disconnection scenarios. I would like to thank you for your attention and watching this video.